IlaGolden and welcome to my vlog. So apparently the video quality is going to be a little bit grainy again. It is actually the morning when I'm filming this, but it is kind of grey and miserable and wet and rainy outside, so I guess that probably has something to do with it. As for what I'm going to talk about this time, that's a very good question. I'm not 100% sure what I want to talk about this time. There are a lot of things that I could talk about. I guess what I should talk about is the fact that We Giants has been released. So it actually went live on the 25th, which is yesterday from when I'm filming this. I didn't do like any big fanfare with it. I didn't do any big announcements with it. I've just kind of just released it, which, yeah, it's a choice. But I think a lot of that's been to do with, obviously, the last couple of months there have been other things going on that I've been having to deal with in my personal life. I haven't really thought too much about it. I mean, this year has definitely not been the kind of year that I thought it would be. So I'm just kind of glad that I've managed to release We Giants at all. Like usual, I'm worried that I've missed grammar mistakes, and I know that I miss grammar mistakes. It doesn't matter how many times I go through it and how carefully I'm going through it, I still miss things. I mean, to be fair, you know, I've read books that have been professionally edited and that still missed things. So it's not, you know, it's just, you know, human error. It's not something I worry too much about. I mean, obviously for some people it's gonna be a big kind of nitpick for them, because some people are very nitpicky when it comes to certain things. But for most readers, I mean, like, as I said, I've read plenty of things where there have been errors, and yeah, that error is a little bit like, oh, that's a bit weird. But it doesn't stop me from enjoying the book. I don't hold those errors against the book, and I think most readers are like that. Not all, and you know, again, I do sort of understand that and I do sort of get that. For some people, like, those little things are just too much for them. I always hope that it's not too terrible. As I said, it's not like I don't go through things lots and lots and lots and lots and lots. And I do get super paranoid that I've missed stuff and whatever else, but there comes a point where you've just got to take that step back and trust that you've caught enough of it for it not to be a problem for most people. But yeah, I always worry and panic that I've left in some like really bad mistake somewhere, or something's gone wrong somewhere. And yeah, this is like, yeah, part of the reason that I struggle so much doing like a big fanfare when I sort of release a book is I'm always really nervous that I haven't done enough. I can't afford to hire a professional editor, and even if I could, like I said, you know, they don't necessarily catch everything. They might sort of give it like a fresh set of eyes, and they might catch something that I haven't, but they're still human, they still may not catch everything, and their job isn't necessarily to catch all the mistakes. Their job is to, you know, quality control it and, you know, stuff like that. So yeah, it's one of those kind of very nerve-wracking kind of, yeah, I've done it, yeah, it's out there now, and there's not really much that I can do. I've just gotta, you know, accept that whatever will happen next will happen next. But it means that the narration series is now complete, which means I can relax a little bit more about using the four boys, four stories sort of tagline that I'm using for the collection. And it also means I can concentrate on the next four books that I'm planning to release. And they are definitely a lot easier to get through. I mean, I was editing this morning. Okay, so whilst I was having to work on my phone, I was sticking to only editing one chapter at a time because it's so awkward editing on your phone in the way that I edit. It's so awkward doing any writing on your phone just in general. It's very difficult to sort of see what's going on with it properly. It's very difficult to make the corrections that you need to. So working on my phone is not really the most conducive to writing or to editing anyway. So during the 3 weeks or so where I was without a laptop, I was only really editing one chapter at a time, because I just felt like that was the safer option, because it was just very awkward having to do the editing, and I didn't want to do too much editing on my phone because that would mean that when I was going through it again, it just felt easier. I mean, even though it was taking slightly longer to do on my phone, because as you know, I use the voice reader to help me with the editing, so I can hear how it's sounding, so I can, you know. Yeah, and the voice read on the phone is a lot slower, so it was taking a little bit longer than it does on the laptop anyway. But yeah, it was mostly it was just the awkwardness of actually having to do the editing, of having to stop and start, in like the number of times I'd accidentally close the document and have to re-find where I was. Yeah, it was just very, very annoying to do on my phone. So just doing it one chapter at a time, as I said, just felt safer. It felt easier for me to work out where I was and what was going on. Also, yeah, it was just easier. This morning is I got my laptop back on Tuesday, but by the time I got it back on Tuesday, I'd already done my morning writing and all the editing that I was planning to do that day. Then yesterday, because I decided I was just going to, instead of, like, I'd been debating for a while whether or not I was going to do another edit of We Giants once I got the laptop back, before actually putting it live, and yesterday morning I was like, you know what, let's just do it, because if I do another edit, I'm just going to want to do another edit, and then I'm going to want to do another edit, and then it's not going to come out this year, it's probably not going to come out till like midway through next year, because I'm never going to be happy with it. Let's just go and just do it in, so instead of doing more than one chapter editing yesterday morning, I instead sorted out the manuscript for Kindle Create. I then also went through the Kindle Create manuscripts for Heiner Boy, The Colours I See and No Doors Allowed, to make sure those all matched up again, and that included adding a content page to the front of all of them, which I didn't previously have, so that had the chapter contents added to the front of them. I also altered the back material for all of them, so they're all consistent, so they all have about the author, the same about the author, and they all have the other books in the series being the other three books to whichever one that particular book was, at least fingers crossed, hopefully I did that correct for all of them. It'd be a bit embarrassing if one of them has itself in the back, but to be fair, I've seen books that had itself in the back by mistake, or whatever, so again, this is what I mean, sometimes professional editors don't always get it right either. I have genuinely seen books which have advertised that book in the back of it, as part of the other books by this author, so yeah, mistakes happen, but as far as I can tell, I've done everything correctly. As I said, there may be like a few errors here and there. I don't expect my writing to be perfect. I know I make mistakes, I know I miss things. I hope I don't miss too many things. I know nitpickers will always exaggerate how many things you miss when they think you're missing a lot of something, or if they're just being generally nitpicky about how you use language in general. So I know I use language in a particular kind of way, which isn't necessarily the way that everybody else uses language, or what I should say is, isn't necessarily the way that most people who read a certain kind of literature are used to language being used. I know my use of language is a little bit more colloquial than most writers tend to use when they're doing like their narration and stuff. I mean, obviously when it comes to the dialogue and stuff, that's a little bit different, but I quite often use a more colloquial style of narration as well, especially if like I'm doing it in first person, because the narration needs to reflect the way the character is talking as much as possible. So yeah, it doesn't always, it's always slightly more refined than how the character talks, but it's still reflective of how the character talks, because the way you think and the way you talk tends to be fairly similar. Obviously there are certain consistencies I have in my writing which are just to do with the way that I use language, which again is probably to do with my own colloquialization and stuff like that. So yeah, I don't worry too much about things. I still worry about things. As I said, I know I'm not a perfect writer. It doesn't matter how many times I go through something or how closely I think I've gone through something, I will still miss things. And as I said, sometimes it's just the way that I use language doesn't necessarily jive particularly well with other people. Sometimes it is just genuine mistakes, because as I said, it can be really hard to pick up on every single little mistake. It just can be, just genuinely can be. Like, it, as I said, it doesn't matter how closely you're sort of following through it, it doesn't matter how many times you spell check it or like go through every single word in as much detail as possible, it's still possible to miss things. So I try, as I said, not to worry too much about it, but like every time I release a book, I'm always like, suddenly, oh my god, I haven't done enough editing. It doesn't matter that I've spent over a year editing this book. Oh my god, I haven't done enough editing. I'm now going to be picking up the pace on the next four book series. I managed to get through three chapters this morning in a reasonable amount of time. I think I started editing the first chapter about 9 o'clock-ish and managed to get through three chapters in about an hour and a half. So that, you know, compared to how long it was taking me to do one chapter of the four book project, and then one chapter of We Giants, which was quite often taking, yeah, at least that long to do, never mind on the occasions when I was trying to do two chapters of it. Yeah, it feels like it's going to be a much easier process to do this series, because the chapter lengths are a lot shorter and it should be a lot easier to get through. So yeah, hopefully my plans for next year will be a little bit smoother, if nothing else. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Because like I said, I just get to a point where it's like, I don't know if I've edited enough. And then I worry and I panic and I edit more and more and more. And I'm like, am I missing stuff? You know, is there something obvious that I haven't noticed? It's just, you know, you just worry about it. And, you know, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how many times I go through it, there are probably always going to be mistakes there somewhere that I just haven't noticed or haven't picked up on. And there's probably less than I think there are. As I said, for some people that's too many. But that's just, as I said, that's just the way it goes. Anyway, I'm going to stop babbling about this now. Hope you found this one sort of interesting. I know it's mostly been me sort of babbling in a kind of nervously, yeah, I've just released a new book kind of way. I hope, as I said, you found it sort of interesting. I hope you're looking forward to seeing whatever it is I'm going to talk about next time. And I will see you next time. See ya.
If you've enjoyed this video, consider checking out some of my others. And if you like what you see, consider liking and subscribing. Thanks for watching. See ya.